the synchronized plucked instruments, you get this electric guitar. It's a 7-string Steve Vai signature guitar. It's a book with 7 seals for most keyboard players, but you have all these articulations in there, and the Synchron Player makes it easy to access those. You always see the articulation, the type of release. You have a normal release and a hard release, and in this case for the long notes, you have different vibrato stages that you can access with your modulation wheel in this case. So let's see what this sounds like. So you can switch between different vibrato stages, even the whammy bar in here, and you can choose between a normal and a hard release. It sounds a little different in the end. You have a more compressed release sound. Can be helpful, and you have it available. Let's go through to the short notes. You can see the key switches, as always, down here, color-coded. So this is the short notes. You have staccatos, short, medium, and hard. And you can use C7 upwards to switch between those. Medium. And hard. Super short staccatos. If you go to the F sharp here on F sharp 6, you have the longest staccatos. But of course, these are not connected notes, but single notes. And the soft version, the attack. Now let's get to the longer version, that's the portato short. And the portato long. With or without vibrato, again, on the modulation wheel. A very intense vibrato for those short notes. And we've been through the long notes already with the whammy bar. You also get harmonics. You get the artificial fifth. The artificial octaves. And the natural harmonics for each string. So starting with the B string here. So as you also see, we've recorded that all the way. And the higher strings, just to have it organized. Talking about sound, of course, the mixer presets are important here. Let's get to the tremolos and trills here instead. Get the halftone trills. Whole tone trills. And of course, with the 7 strings, you get very low. We'll get to that a little later. You also get super low tuned, the B0. And the trill with the major third here. So again, you can choose between a soft and a hard release. All the options you see here are always, that's what's available for you to control those different notes. Really cool, the grace notes, those pickup notes. You have a grace noise to start with. Here you can hear it even clearer, the rougher the sound is, the more you will hear a difference between the normal released note and the compressed hard release. Let's play through the octaves with this grace noise. Then you have octave harmonics. And the whammy bar. And the whammy bar with octaves, again harmonics. I really feel like I should grow my hair a little bit longer. This is a lot of fun too. Power chords, fourths, fifths, majors, and minors. Now let's talk a little bit about the sound that you can achieve with a guitar. You have different mixer presets, as with every instrument, but in this case you have an orchestra setup. The Overdrive guitar opens with the Overdrive classic centered setup. But of course you get different mixer presets that will also give you a more processed sound, just using the included effects that you find in the integrated mixer here. So going away from the sound that we recorded and that is a little reverberated. Double phased. And let's check out the solo section. Fifths here. And the overdrive echoes with a few delays in the back. Major power chords and minor power chords. Let's go to the Overdrive Ghost mixer preset here on the right hand side. These are good starting points for whenever you're looking for the guitar sound you want to find. And the totally freaked out overdrive flying around sound. Let's just go for the fourths again. That could be a powerful opening. We're going back to the Overdrive Classic Center. That's no processing additionally, but of course you can go crazy with all the effects that you find in here, from equalizer over these different distortions. You have saturators, cabinets, you have different filters, modulations. Just play around with those effects and see how you can get your guitar sound. Okay, next up, it's the effects. So you have some feedback, ebow, tuned down, and different scratches on the strings. Let's just have a listen through those. And we're starting with the feedback soft. And the feedback hard. The ebow. And the tuned down section. So you see we've tuned down the lowest string of the guitar to go even deeper. The trick here is that those low-tuned strings are swinging so slowly that it's really hard to control them. That's why they're also really good to have in the repetition section. And you also have to make sure as they're swinging a little bit wider than they're supposed to, you have to really play very controlled. That's what I learned from the recordings. So this is an interesting option there. Whenever you're looking for a good low end, here you have one. Then we've got different scratches on the E string. So you can just choose whatever you find suitable, scratches on the B string. They may sound all the same, but they are very different, believe me. Scratches with the whammy bar. And some scratch effects. Definitely good to spice up a solo piece there. Finally, we're getting to the legato. We have to find the right key switches here. Again, different options. Connecting notes with a bend in between. With a soft connection. Here you have a lot of options again with the modulation wheel. With vibrato. The whammy bar. And the second whammy bar. Then you have a hard, a more articulated connection. Again, switching between those different vibrators options. You have a marcato, even more articulated than the hard connection. And hammer on and pull off. Repetitions. Here you got different note lengths with the single notes portato. Portato version 2, so you have got a lot of options there. You have a crescendo. Diminuendo with 9 repetitions. Crescendo with 9 repetitions. Same with the second option here, the second diminuendo. And then you've got muted versions, 1, 1 and 2. And of course, the tuned down version here, where you have repetitions with the low, very slow swinging strings. And of course, the same thing also for the highly useful power chords. So, fourths. Fifths. Crescendo and diminuendo variations again with fourths and fifths, with five repetitions this time. And the diminuendo part of it. And the fifths here. And the diminuendo. Finally, we've got some fast repetitions, so you can choose between steady 140 to 220 BPM. Those key switches are up here, just going to skip to 200 BPM right away. You have a crescendo there. You have a diminuendo. Maybe a little slower here. And then you have the diminuendo. And you have a noise variation in here as well. We're coming to the scale runs, and we've been practicing here a lot. Starting with a major up, you always have the scale of the selected scale that you're checking. So in this case, it's major up, C major up. And of course, you can stop those runs in between and then connect it with another articulation. So if I'm going for E-flat major, I'm just playing the notes that E-flat major actually works with. The same downwards. And the same also with the harmonic minor up and minor down. So you have all the different modes for all these scales available, and you can mix it up and connect it with all the other articulations that you find here in the Overdrive guitar.